In this video, I'm going to talk about a new recurrent batch job for managing the release of picking to warehouse in production. This illustration shows a production order with two operations, an assembly operation and a painting operation. Before the assembly operation can start, material needs to be picked for the operation. When the assembly operation is completed, the paint material needs to be picked and ready for the painting job. The purpose of the batch job is to release the materials for picking in the warehouse. As the illustration indicates, the job can be configured to only release materials within a defined time fence. The materials that are applicable for release do not have to be physically reserved for the batch job to release them. The batch job will only release as much of the material that is physically available when the job runs. Any remaining quantity will be released by the job as soon as it becomes physically available. You can use the batch job to avoid keeping unnecessary reservations on materials by setting up a release time fence. You can minimize inventory levels on the shop floor and improve space utilization. You can save time and cost by less manual interaction in the release process. I'm now going to show a demo of the scenario. With this feature, a new production control parameter, production line release, has been introduced. This parameter has two values: on production order release and batch job or manually controlled. If on production order release is selected, production picking is released to warehouse as part of releasing the production order. If batch job or manually controlled is selected, production picking will not be released when the production order is released. With this setting, production picking can only be released using a batch job or as a manual interaction. In this example, we will select batch job or manually controlled. A production order for a cabinet assembly is prepared for this example. The production order has three lines for bill of materials, also known as BOM lines. Each BOM line has been set to manual reservation. The production order status is scheduled, and the scheduling result can be seen from the Gantt chart. The order has two operations, an assembly operation and a packing operation. The assembly operation consumes two materials. This can be viewed from the job dialog box. The packing operation consumes one material. I'm now going to release the production order. No materials are released when I release the production order. This is because of the new production control parameter, is set to batch job or manually controlled. I'm now going to use the batch job automatic release of BOM and formula lines for releasing the materials in the production order. Here is the dialog box for the batch job. I'm using the filter options to set up criteria for the job. In this case, I'm going to use the query value less than date as a criterion for the raw material date. By using the query value less than date 2, only lines with the material date within the time fence of the next 2 days will be released. I'm now going to confirm the job. After the job has been completed, the info log shows that materials has been released to the warehouse. When I go back to the production order, I can see that work has been generated. This can be seen from the Work Details page. Note that only materials for the assembly operation has been released to warehouse. This is because only the assembly operation falls within the time fence of the query. The query value for the material that are used is dynamic, so the materials for the packing operation will be released as soon as they fall within the time fence of the query.